Hello everyone, welcome back to Automation Engineer. Today I will start the series of Wonderware System Platform. So we come to part 1, Introduction. Firstly, I will talk about the Intouch Standalone. Intouch Standalone is an application Windows-based. This is the application for the SMI or the SCADA. Intouch will take the data, the value, the signal directly from the PLC and the other device to the software. And we will use the Intouch Window Maker to create the HMI page, and we use the Window Viewer to view, to control, to assign the control signal to the PLC or take the value from the PLC to the HMI. We also have the historical data to see the trend. And we also have the device integration. Device integration will help us to connect with the PLC and the other device. For example, scanner here, the motor here. But the Intouch Standalone have one disadvantage. The Intouch application just you only on the desktop or the laptop have the program and connect to the PLC directly to the PLC. This means when the desktop or the laptop damaged, so we cannot control the process by Wonderware Intouch Standalone. And one more thing, with the Intouch Standalone, we cannot control at home. For example, when we have the day off, when we don't go to the factory or the site, so we cannot see the status of the process, the operation, and we cannot control. So that's why we have the Wonderware System Platform. So we come to the Wonderware System Platform. What is the System Platform? System Platform is an industrial software platform built on the architecture technology. It contains an integrated set of service and intangible data model to manage the plant control and information management system. This is the example for plant control. This is the site here. Site, it means the factory. In factory, we have plant 1 and plant 2. In plant 1, we have area 1 and area 2. In plant 2, we have the area 1, 2, and 3. So we convert to the system platform with the same structure. Implement Pro, it means the site, the whole factory. Manage guy here is the plan 1, and in plan 1 we have milling flotation here. This is the area 1 and area 2, and the smaller is the plan 2. In plan 2 we will have area 1 here, dryer, 2 furnace, area 3 a converter. This is the one example. And for the information management system here, with the Wonderware System Platform, we can see all the data on the SMI or the SCADA. Here, we have many check here, many type of check. Next, System Platform support both for the supervisory control layers and the manufacturing execution system. This means MES layer, presenting them as a single information source. This is the supervisory control layer. We can control the agitator, the bump, the valve here, and we can see the level of the tank, the temperature. It's the same with the in-touch standalone. But we can open this application in many desktop or laptop, or even we can open this application and control at home. We just need the Wi-Fi. Okay. And this is the MES system. The MES system within the system platform, we can link to the system, the other system, such as AMM or SAB, to take the data on that system. For example, like PO, like BOM, PO of material, process order, and the other value, other data. This is the pyramid of the automation here. For the in-touch standalone, we just stop here at the layer of SCADA SMI. But with the system platform, we can come to the next level, MES. Okay, so that's the one of advantage of system platform compared with the in-touch standalone. System platform and its client provide the framework and tools for developing, executing, monitoring, and visualizing your application here. And system platform also have the service such as data acquisition, historization, alarming. They are provided by system platform component. And we have the service such as visualization, trending, and provided by system platform client. Here, this is the example for the alarming provided by a component of system platform. And this is the, for example, this is the symbol for trending provided by system platform client. And the system platform software is based on the industry standards and Microsoft technologies such as Windows, .NET, and SQL Server. And the final is Architecture provide the fundamental technology and service for the multi-user object-oriented platform. So this is the component and client of the system platform, even the structure of system platform. At the bottom here, the system platform component assess and process the internal data from controller here. The software application and other data sources here. And the system platform client, we assess the information from the system platform here. So we come to the second layer, system platform. Firstly, we talk about the application server. Application server is the heart of the system platform. It provides an object-oriented framework with the tools for developing and deploying the applications. And the second thing is the historian. The historian provides process data historization and alarm and events logging for the application server. The data is exposed through SQL Server and or an open data protocol OData interface. And the last component of the system platform is the device integration servers. Device integration server are the driver for communication with the third-party controller. this come to the form of OI server, the legacy of TA server, and the legacy of IO server. System platform also work with the third-party driver such as OPC server. So that's the component. That's the packs of the system platform. So the next one is about the system platform client. We come to the top layer. The system platform client includes the first pack is the supervisory client here. The supervisory client run the operator interface and provide the real-time access to the application server data, alarm, and event. There are two supervisory client products based on the different technologies, but both can coexist in the same system platform solution. The first supervisory client product is the operation management interface here. Pointer here. Operation management interface had a graphic design visualization framework with the tools. Sorry, okay, here. Operation management interface have a rapid design visualization framework with the tools and provide out of the box navigation to display the content based on the application data model here. And the second product is the InTouch for system platform. InTouch for system platform is based on the traditional development tool to create the displays and the corresponding navigation framework from scratch. This is about the supervisory client. The next part of the system platform client is a Hitorian client here. Hitorian client. Hitorian client is a collection of tools for assessing and reporting on the data Hitorized with the Hitorian. This client includes a train application for the plot data on the graphical display, and query application for the conducting SQL queries through a point and click interface and edge into the Microsoft Excel and Word for generating the report. And the final one is Insight. Insight is a browser-based tool for the quick data query, training, and analysis of data historized with the Hitorian. It provides intuitive interface for easy access and use. So system platform and its client provide the core service needed to develop, implement, and deploy the industrial automation applications. Some of these services include the first is the real-time data acquisitions from the field device. This means the field device means the PLC, the motor, the scanner, and other device. The second service is a scaling statistics and manipulation of the data. The third one is process control. The fourth one is alarm triggering, logging, acknowledgement and management. The next one is about historization training and analysis of process data. Visualization of real-time process data, and final one is reporting. Okay, so it's done for the system platform. Thank you for your watching. In the next video, I will introduce about how to create the blend deployment in the Acacia IDE. Thank you for your watching. See you in the next video.